Yes, in the previous lecture, we discussed about the different type of scenarios, decision making structure. That is decision making under certainty, decision making under uncertainty, decision making with probability or risk, decision making with perfect information, etc. Then we discussed about the three types were there. Today, inshallah, we will discuss in detail what are these three types were there. Maximax, for example, for the Maximax, let me change the color. For the Maximax, maximum equal likely. Today we will discuss in detail what are these different types were there for the category of decision making under uncertainty. Let's talk about what are decision making under uncertainty as the concept is for the uncertainty means no knowledge about the future state of the nature. We do not have any knowledge about the probability of, or we do not have any knowledge about the probability. Moreover, we don't know about the future state of the nature. Then about the, what are the payoff table? Payoff table means decision making against some data they are available. This concept will be clear in the next slide when we have the example. Then we have the payoff. What are the concept for the payoff? What is the return of the decision? Then let's see. Payoff table analysis can be applied. Means recall that in order to have the analysis, we may have a different mechanism with the table. Right now we are discussing the mechanism with the payoff table. Then when we apply the payoff table, the means we need to make the analysis of what will be the return. Then it will be applied. Can be applied when there's a finite set of discrete decision alternative. We can discrete decision alternative, we can count them. Or option number one, option number two, option number three, we can count them. They are discrete. We can count them. And they are also finite number. It is not something infinite. We can count, for example, we can easily count them. Okay, it is not infinite. Moreover, they are also discrete, not the continuous. The outcome of the decision is a function of a single event. Means what will be the outcome of this event? Of this event means some single function, some single output. As we saw in the previous slide, we talk about the outcome one, outcome two, outcome three, etc. Then about the, in the payoff table, the row obviously it consists of some rows and columns. As we will show in the next slide, it consists of rows and columns. The row represent the what is the alternative, and the column represent the what are the, and the column represent the possible state of the nature. Then the state of the nature are mutually exclusive and collectively exhaustive. What does it mean? They mutually exclusive. It means only one event, only one of the state of nature will occur at a time. This is mutually exclusive. About the collectively exhaustive means even all together make up everything that can possibly we can happen. Then the table entries are the payoff. For now it will be more clear what are payoff, what are the column, what are the rows were there. Let me show you. For example, these are row number 1, row 2, row 3, row 4, row 5, etc. Column 1, column 2, column 3, column 4, column 5. And moreover, these all represent the alternative or option number 1. Option 1, option 2, option 3, etc. These columns represent the state of the nature. These are the state of the nature over there, as we saw. Moreover, these are the represent the payoff or the return of the decision. What are the reason? What will be the outcome? These outcome represent these outcome. We need to make the analysis. Come back to the previous slide. As we talk about the rows, column, state of the nature, and the table entries. Now, starting with the scenario. Suppose Ahmed has an inherent. Ahmed somehow get the 1,000 riyal. I have given number of times this example that suppose I have 1 million riyal, I want to make the investment so that I want to have some profit. Obviously, number of options were there. Either I can purchase the real estate, I have option number two, I can invest in the purchasing of the gold. Number three, I can purchase the shares of IPO, etc. So, the similar example were there. He has to decide how to invest the money for 1 year, means he wants to make the investment for 1 year. He asked the broker, the broker gave the five potential investment. Number one, invest in gold. investment company A, company B, company C, company D, then what is the return? Each of the return of the investment, they depend upon uncertainties, market behavior. For example, when they start, in the start of the investment, then and at the end, after 1 year, the market fluctuate, market make changes. Then for each investment, there is about the five options, what we have found, five options, there are some uncertainties over there. Then Ahmed would, but what Ahmed will do, he will make a payoff table. Based on the payoff table, he will make a decision about the investment decision. Let's see what are these. Suppose he make a payoff table for this one, and he found these five alternative gold company, investment company A, B, C, D. There are five options were there, or five alternatives were there. These are the moreover of these are five state of the nature, means uncertainties were there. Either the market will be large rise for the 1 year, or market can be, or possibility can be a small rise, and there is no change, there is a small fall, market will fall, a small fall at the end of the year, or market can be large fall or heavy loss. Then each of these state of the nature, then that these are represented payoff. Payoff means represent the what will be the return, what will be the return of the decision. What we need to do, we need to make the analysis, Ahmed make a decision analysis. Then let's see how do we solve this type of category. Recall that today we will discuss the scenario only for the decision making for the uncertainty only. Then here what we found, the step number one, for example, as it is for, it is written here that the company A and the company D. The company D alternative is dominated by company A alternative. The company D, company A, means all of the payoff return for the company A, company D, it is dominated, means somehow will be cover up in the A. So what we can do, we can drop them. Why do we require drop them? Because when we started the experiment, when we started working on them, sometime we have very large number of options were there, very large number. What we need to do in order to make the simplification, some of the miss, some are undominated or something, they are not very critical or does not have, maybe they were covered up by the rest of the options were there, we can drop them. So to make easiness here, they give the example, they give them, because of subdominancy, it is already covered up in the here what we found, decreasing. Okay, then if the more decrease, for example here, then minus 150 means these how, in other words, we can say they are dominate, cover the option for the D will be cover up for the option for I. So we can drop number D. So in the practical scenario, sometime suppose we have the 50 alternatives over there, what we will do in order to make the simplification, some of the unimportant one or undominated, we will drop them. Now, what we will do, decision making criteria. What are the criteria for the decision making? Because that we are discussing about the decision making under uncertainty. The concept for the uncertainty means all of the decision, they depend on the lifestyle of the decision maker or manager. The manager, whoever the manager, it depends upon some of the manager, they are very aggressive. Some of the manager, they can be very bold, very aggressive. Some of the manager, no, they are very conscious or something. They, in order to make any decision, they a lot of thinking were there. So for this category, for the decision making under uncertainty, okay, it depend on the lifestyle of the decision maker, attitude toward the life in the decision maker. Example is, I will give a simple example. Suppose you are on the road and you are very near to the signal, traffic signal. The traffic signal is the light of the traffic signal is changed from green to orange. Maybe after three or four seconds it will be changed into red. What I commonly found, some of the driver, they are what they do, just they speed up and they cross the signal. Whereas on the other end, some of the driver, what they do is they saw that the orange light, they stop it, or they are not willing to pass the pass the traffic signal. So these are some of the life cycle of the decision maker. Let's see what are the five categories were there. Four categories were there for this criteria. Maximum criteria, then minimax regret criteria, maximax criteria, and the principle of insufficient reason or no or maybe something in between them. Let's see what are the features were there. For the maximum criteria, there are some pessimistic or the conservative approach. But these are the, we can say, the worst case scenario. Always think, simple example for the a glass is if filled with a half glass is filled with water. A glass half filled with water. Some of the, it depends on the lifestyle of the viewer who want to, how he perceive the half glass. With some of them, they can perceive as the glass is half filled, or half filled means half, the glass is half empty. Okay, this represents something about the pessimistic or conservative. Moreover, sometimes some of the viewer, they see the glass is half filled. Half filled means they are something optimistic, etc. So again, these are the lifestyle, and these lifestyles somehow influence to make the decision. So maximum criteria, they will fill up for the case for the pessimistic or conservative. Second one are the mini max regret. Again, they are the pessimistic conservative approach. Then we have the maximist optimistic or aggressive approach. Or optimistic means they always see the glass is half filled. Then the last one is about the principle of insufficient, is a no information about likelihood of the various state of the nature. Or in other words, we can say these type of the decision maker, neither they are pessimistic nor they are optimistic. Neither they are pessimistic nor optimistic. Some, they are something in between them. They have all the state of the nature, they think that they are all equally likely. Now we'll discuss each of these type one by one. What are these? One about the maximum. Notice we are talking about the maximum criteria. Let's see how it is. Again, this is the third time I'm emphasizing that. Today we will discuss about the all of the subcategories in the subcategories for the decision making under uncertainty. Maximum, maximax, regret, insufficient. Later on, we will discuss about the decision making with risk. So their subcategories are different. So moreover, the one of the property for the decision making under uncertainty are that the decision they are make or somehow influenced by the lifestyle of the decision maker. Another category, that is decision making for the risk, it does not have the lifestyle of the decision maker does not have any influence for the decision making. Later on we will discuss. Today we are not discussing about the first one. What are these? The criteria, this is maximum based on the worst case scenario. What worst can happen? For example, it fit both for the pessimistic and the conservative decision maker. What are the pessimistic and what are the conservative? First, we need to know what is the pessimistic and what the conservative decision maker. Pessimistic decision maker believe that the worst case possible events will always occur. He always think there must be something. He always think the glass is half empty. Or something he can say. When he make the investment, he think, there is a loss. He always talking about something about the loss. Obviously, something about loss means he want to save himself for the probable loss. So they have model for their for the pessimistic. He always think there must be something bad can happen. There can be loss. Then, so the second type about the conservative decision. Conservative again, it is a scenario for the worst case scenario. But he wishes to ensure the guarantee minimum possible. He must want to make the guarantee. Means if always ask for the guarantee. What is the minimum possible? Possible. For example, he want to make the investment for 1,000 dirham. Might be possible. Before the investment, he asked, okay, please give me the guarantee for that I will have the minimum profit of 50 dirham, for example. Minimum, it means he always asked to make the insurance, make assurance that what is the minimum possible payoff? What is the minimum possible payoff? At least it means someone, if give them guarantee that okay, you will get at least whatever the scenario, you will get 50 riyal out of the investment of 1000 riyal, then this is the type of the lifestyle of the decision maker. Please keep this mind concept in this mind. Pessimistic, conservative, and both of them they were cover up with the worst scenario for the maximum. Let's see. Again, starting with a simple decision, as well, the table is the same as we saw in the previous slide. We have four options, four alternative ones. The alternative are the gold, company A, company B, company C investment. These are the decision, four decisions were there, four alternative were there. And we have the five state of the nature, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. What is represent? The for the rest of the chapter, we will discuss these five state of the nature. One is large rise. One event can be large rise. Second event can be the small rise, no change, small change. And as we saw in the previous slide, this is the table. We have saw some number, some payoff, they were given to us. Some payoff, for it means this part is the same for the rest of the chapter. Some payoff value, they were given to us. These are the state of the nature, and these are the alternative. What we need to do, we will apply different criteria for different scenarios. Okay, they are the same. Starting with the for the maximum criteria, what first let's have a look, then I will discuss in the description. First, in the maximum criteria, first found what for each of the decision, what is the minimum value, or in other words, we can say for each of the row, what is the minimum value? What is the minimum value? Minus 100, 100. 200, 300, 0, the minimum value is 100. What about the, what is the second minimum value? Row, what is the minimum value for the second option is minus 150. Third one about the minus 600. Fourth one is about the minus 60. It means, in other words, for each of the alternative, each of the option, find for each of the row, what is the minimum value? Let me clear it. Once we identify the minimum value, but these are the minimum payoff, minimum value. Out of this minimum value, what is the maximum value? First identify the minimum value, as we saw here, the minimum value. Then out of this, then for this column, just for this column, what is the maximum value? All of the values, they are the negative except the last one. The last one is positive. So this will be our optimal decision. Optimal decision for the maximum criteria for the given table, he will opt for the investment in company C. Investment in company C because it has the maximum value. Now let's talk about what the description were there. To find the optimal decision, record the minimum payoff across the all of the. First, we will find out what is the minimum payoff across whole of the table. Then identify the decision with maximum payoff. Then we will identify what is the maximum payoff. This is the criteria. Now let's talk about the another mini-max regret criteria. Mini-max regret criteria. Okay, first I will show the starting with the numerical. Then I will come back to these concepts. First, starting with the numerical. Again, the same payoff is given to us. As I just mentioned about the for the rest of the chapter, we will follow the same four options, four alternative, and five payoff. We will discuss for the five payoff. Step number one, first we will identify for each of the state of the nature or for each of the column, what is the maximum value. What the maximum value for the first column is, the maximum value is 500. Minus 100, 250, 500, says the maximum value is 500. Okay, choose this 500. What is the second maximum value? This is the second maximum value. What is the maximum value for the third column? The maximum value for the third column is 200. What about the maximum value for the small fall state of the nature? For this, what is the maximum value? The maximum value is 300. What about the last one? About the last one, what is the maximum value? The maximum value is 60. This is the maximum value. Once you identify the maximum value, what will you do? The rest of the value will be subtracted. I mean, the rest of the value will be subtracted from the maximum value. For example, here, what is the first payoff for the large size? Minus 100. I just mentioned about is subtracted 500 minus here 500 minus 100 equal to minus plus 600. What about second one? How do we compute this one? 500, the maximum value, minus this payoff, then it will be equal to 500 minus 250 is 250. What about the third one? 500 minus 500 is 0. What about the last one? 500 minus 60 is equal to 440. Again, I'm emphasizing, first we'll identify for each of the value, what is the maximum value? Once you identify the maximum value, the rest of the payoff value should be subtracted. This value should be subtracted from the maximum value. The same you can apply here, maximum value. All of the value will be subtracted. Then it is equal to 250 minus 100, then 250, then 250 minus 200, then 250 minus 250, then 250 minus 60 is equal to 190. In the same way, this process will continue, so that what we are trying to do, we will create a regular table. First, we will create a regular table. This is what we known as regular table. Then what will be the next step? In this slide, they mention what is the process we are doing. Then identify the maximum value for each of the column. Then the rest of the value will be subtracted. As we saw in the previous slide, then what we will do, then make a regular table for the regular table. This is the same. Until this part, we did not do anything. Just a step they are trying to. Once we identify or create a regular table, then what we will do, find what is the maximum value. What is the maximum regret? What is the maximum regret? The maximum value for each of the alternative. These are the maximum value is 600. 600. What is the maximum value? The maximum value is 400. Mentioned here. What is the maximum value here? The maximum value is 660. This is 660. What is the maximum value here? The maximum value is here is 440. 440. So it means what we have done? We create a regression table. Then we will find out the maximum regret. These are the maximum regret. Out of this maximum regret, what is the minimum value? The minimum value will be our answer. This is the minimum value for the maximum regret. 400, it means for the decision maker who have the lifestyle or will follow of the minimax regret criteria, he will follow, his optimal decision will be investment company A. Come back in the previous concept as, what is the minimum maximum criteria are? The criteria fit the pessimistic and the conservative approach. Means, as we saw, what is conservative, what is pessimistic? Means something, they always see the glass is half empty. Then the payoff table is based on the loss opportunity regress. This payoff table, what we created is, we'll create a loss table as a regret table or the lost opportunity. The decision maker incurred a regret by failing to choose the best decision. Then these are the, for example, these are the decision maker who will incur regret, this is a loss, by failing to choose the best decision. As we saw in the steps, what are these? Then these are the regret, in which first we will identify the what is the maximum value, maximum regret, they find what is the minimum regret. So what is the step? For each of the step, first they find the best payoff. Best payoff means what is the maximum value for each of the column. Calculate the regret. Now we will calculate regret table for each of the alternative. And the difference between the payoff and the where, what if then, what that it is a difference of the payoff and the best payoff value or the maximum value. Then for each of the decision and the find the maximum regret, what we find? First we find out what is the maximum mean in the regret table, what is the maximum value for each of the option or in the row. Then select the alternative that has a minimum value. Once we identify the maximum regret, then for maximum regret, then which option need to be choose, or which, what's the optimal decision? Optimal decision will be for those which has the minimum value. If these are the maximum regret, out of this maximum regret, this is the minimum value, it will be the optimal decision or investment company investment A. The optimal decision investment, the the optimal, this is the optimal decision, investment company. Now let's talk about another important criteria is a maxi-max criteria. Means the first part represent the alternative. The second part is the about the outcome. Let's see. In the maximum criteria, as I mentioned in the previous slides for the discussion, that the some of the decision makers, they are very aggressive. They always see the glass is half filled. They always try to capture any opportunity. How is more? Whenever they found an opportunity, they will try to avail. These are the these are the features. Let's see what are the and how do we calculate. The criteria is based on the best possible scenario. These criteria, they based on the best possible scenarios. It fit for optimistic and the aggressive decision maker. It will fit for optimistic or the aggressive decision maker who always see, means if they found what is more opportunity, if they want to avail this opportunity. Otherwise, for example, let me suppose that right now, because of the coronavirus, some of the investors, they try to reluctant about the investment because uncertainty is there. So on the other hand, if there is some aggressive decision maker, even for this uncertainty, they try to find some opportunity. Example is during this last 1 year in the corona period or the pandemic era, all of the rest of the business all over the world, they are in the loss. Amazon, their profit has been this much more. Amazon, why? Because of the corona, because of the lockdown, people prefer to have the online shopping. It means whatever the scenario they have, they always try to capture whatever the opportunity they will find. An optimal decision maker believes that the best possible outcome will always take place regardless of the decision made. He always thinks there is something good can happen. And the placement regardless of the denote means whatever the decision means, for each of the decision, they always have something possibility for the goodness. So it means they will choose the what will be the maximum. An aggressive decision maker looks for the decision with the highest payoff when the payoff is the profit. Suppose the payoff table somehow represent the profit or large sale, increase in the sale, the value in the payoff table. Then what they do? He look for the decision with the highest payoff. He will figure out what is the maximum payoff for each of the alternative, each of the decision, and pick up and they follow that mechanism. To find the optimal decision, what they do? Find the maximum payoff for each of the alternative and find select the decision alternative that the maximum payoff. I think a little bit you are something that these texts something about the confusing, but in the next slide when we solve the numerical, then I think this concept will be very clear. But just keep in mind, we are discussing about the maximax criteria, in which he is the decision maker lifestyle is something about the opportunistic or something they are the aggressive, something aggressive. Then they always try to find, they always think there must some good can happen. This part of the table, they are the same as I mentioned for this. Yeah, we have four alternative. We have five state of the nature. What we need to find for each of the alternative, for each of the option, what is the maximum value? So what is the maximum value for this row? This is the maximum value. What is the maximum value for this row? This is the maximum value. What is the maximum value for this row or option? This is the maximum value. And because in the last one, all of the value, they are the same. All of the value are the same. So we can write this one. Here in this column, first we will identify what is the maximum payoff for each of the decision. Maximum payoff is 300. Maximum payoff for the option number company A is 250, then 560. It means in this column, what we identify? We identify what is the maximum payoff for each of the decision. that once we identify, when we compute this column, then we will compute the maximum payoff. Out of this maximum, what is the maximum value? So 300, 250, 500, 660. What is the maximum value? The maximum value is 500. On the other hand, we can say the optimal decision should be the invest in company B. For the decision maker, following the maximum criteria, he will make the investment in company B. Now let's talk about the insufficient reason. First, we will compute the this. Then I will come back. Recall that, for example, let's come back to the previous concept as. Okay, for this one, in order to compute for the last category, okay, as I mentioned that these tables are the same. What is sum of this option number one? What is sum for each of the option? What is found? Minus 100 plus 100 is 0, 200, 300, 500. Even it is 500. What about the second one? Make a summation. 250, 200 is equal to 450. Then plus 150 is equal to 600. 600 minus 100 is equal to 500. 500 minus 150 is equal to 350. Or in other words, just make a summation for the all of the payoff for the last one. Last value is 300. What about this one? 500, 600, 700, 750, 750 minus 200 is 550. 550 minus, so what I just mentioned about the make a summation, it is equal to minus 800 and year equal to 500, 600, 700, 850. So then summation is equal to 50. So in other words, we can say just make a summation of all of the alternative. Come back to the concept as. For the first one, total sum payoff is 500. Second one, 350. Third one is about the 50. For the company investment, company is about 60. Now, once you identify the summation of payoff for all of the alternative, then we find what is the maximum value. What is the maximum value? The maximum value is 500. It means for the here he will make the investment in gold because it has the highest value. Or in simple, I can say decision maker who will follow up the insufficient reason, neither optimistic nor pessimistic, then he will follow some maximum value for the sum of the payoff, and based on this one he will make the investment gold based on the criteria, the optimal decision investment gold, because it is the highest value. Come back to the previous slide. What are the description? Insufficient reason, let's see. Insufficient reason or neither pessimistic nor optimistic between them. The criteria might be appealed to a decision maker who is neither optimistic or the pessimistic. It means something in between them. Or he thinks that there is equal likely chance of every event, all of the events. It assumes that all of the state of the nature are equally likely to occur. He thinks that all of the state of the nature that are four, small rise, small fall, large fall, no change, they can equally likely to be occur. Then what about the what is the procedure? The procedure, either we can make a summation or make an average, doesn't matter. For each of the decision, all the add or make a summation of all the payoff. Select the decision with the largest sum. So what we have done? Okay. Here, although for example, here a lot of calculation will be required. In the, for example, here hundreds of the software they are available, or financial institution who was the financial institution. For example, right now we are discussing about the decision making and uncertainty. Then we will discuss about the decision making and risk. What I need to mention that in the market software they are available. Just enter the payoff, all of the calculation, these automatically be done. Just give them some input, all of the report will be generated automatically. For example, let's see, for the these are the state of the nature as we saw. These are the payoff table as we saw in the start. Options were there, then they are the state of the nature, they are the their payoff. As we saw, working on this payoff. What about this one? For the maximum criteria, the first case, he will make the investment in company C and this is his payoff. For the second one is about the minimax criteria, he will make the investment in company A. Moreover, his payoff will be 400. If the decision maker, his lifestyle is something about the maximax criteria, he will make the investment in company B and this is his payoff. If the insufficient decision means neither optimistic nor pessimistic, then he will make the investment in gold. Then and this is his payoff. What for example, right now we are discussing about this sub very few cases, or moreover, very few state of the nature, very few alternatives. Then but software applications, they are available. What just enter the input, automatically they will generate the report. So right now, more of we also until now we did not discuss little bit more the calculations such as we can enter the probability. A little bit more calculation will be required there, but it automatically can be done with just use of the Excel sheet or just use some software they are available then. Now let's talk about the decision and uncertainty can present a problem if the attitude toward life. What we found, one of the problem for the decision making in the category of decision making under uncertainty means it depend on the lifestyle of the decision maker. One of the problem we identify, if there is mood of the decision maker or the manager changing rapidly, means he will change his mood very rapidly, then if we may found some of the problem. Let's see what are these. Decision making under uncertainty can present a problem if the attitude towards life, optimistic, pessimistic, or somewhere in between them, changing rapidly. If he will make changes, but might possible sometime he will very aggressive, sometime he is pessimistic, sometime he is optimistic or conservative, etc. Then, and this behavior is changing very fast, then we may found some of the problem. We found this is the problem. Then we will go, then what we will go? We will go some other techniques were there. What are, it means the technique should not, the technique should be such that it will cover up the problem for the lifestyle of the decision maker, or in other words, the technique should, they should not include the lifestyle of the decision maker. Then what is the technique? The decision making under risk. We will see later on what are these. Obtain the probability estimate. Then first, somehow we get the probability estimate for each of the state of the nature and implement an implementation based on the decision making under risk. What are the property for the decision making under risk? Means the decision what we are making in this category, it somehow we are not required, somehow does not involve the lifestyle of the decision maker. It only required some probability number will be required. This is the basic idea. We keep this mind, this concept in mind. What are the difference between them? Now let's talk about the, what are the decision making under risk? I mean probabilistic decision maker, decision situation. Whereas decision making under uncertainty, then here we do not have any probability. Then state of the nature, each of the state of the nature, as we saw, small rise, small fall, large fall, etc. We must have some probability. Each of the state of the nature have probability of occurrence. The probability estimate for the occurrence, each of the, if available, can be incorporated in the such optimal decision. Whatever the probability what we get, somehow we get the probability for each of the state of the nature, this will be included for the calculation for the optimal decision. For each decision calculate, how do we calculate the value? Then we will follow up the concept for the expected payoff. We will compute the expected payoff. then how do we compute the expected payoff? Noted that whenever you see the word expected means some chance, some occurrence, then always keep your mind it is something associated with the probability. Then how do we compute the expected payoff? Is the probability multiplied by the payoff. Just means somehow the each of the payoff in the table it will be incorporated with the probability and make a summation as we saw in the previous. The rest means make a summation. The important thing is each of the payoff must be associated with the corresponding probability. Select the decision with the best expected payoff, maximum value what we get, then we will choose the maximum what we get in the will be our decision. Let's see what are these concepts. The tables are the same as we saw in the previous slide. This is the table. These are the same as we saw. We have the four alternatives were there. We have the five state of the nature as we saw here. What is new? Something in this slide is we have each of the state of the nature, we have the probability. Each of the state of the nature, we somehow have the probability. 0.2, 0.3, 0.3, 0.1, 0.1. These are the probability over there. Associated with each of the state of the nature. What we need to do in order to make the decision, we must consider these probability. Then how do we compute? For example, how do we compute the first one? How do we compute the, for example, here they mentioned about this one. Let me first, I will do, then I will do next. Expected value for the investment in company A, how do we compute probability? Let me clear it. This probability, these are the probability multiplied by the payoff plus, make a summation, probability multiplied by the payoff plus probability multiplied by the payoff, then probability multiplied by the payoff. Probability multiplied by the payoff. Then make a summation. Make a summation means it is equal to 130. This is from company A. We also need to compute for all of the alternative, that is company A. The same exercise we will do for the company B, same for the company C, same for the gold. Then the same for the gold. As we saw, when we make the calculation for the gold, the expected value is 100. When we make the calculation for the company B, what will we get? The expected value 125 and 60. These are the expected value for the corresponding decision. 100, 130, 125 and 60. What we need to do? What is the maximum value? What is the maximum value? The maximum value we found is equal to 130. So it means the terminology used as expected return of the expected value, EREV, expected return of the expected value. How do we calculate? We calculate from the expected value. These are expected value. That what is the maximum value for the expected value is 100, 130, 125, 60. 100, 130, 125, 60. The maximum value is 130. This is our optimal. So from the expected value, the maximum value will be selected. And it will be expected return of the expected value. Please notice that this is important terminology. This is very important terminology. Expected return of the expected value, because this will be used for the rest of the calculation. Okay, we will stop right now. Inshallah, we will continue the next lecture. On Tuesday, you will have your quiz at 5 o'clock on Tuesday. We have already uploaded the guidelines. Just make you reminded. Thank you very much. Now you may leave the session. Thank you very much.